Hey guys, if you're looking for how you can run C programs in your favorite Visual Studio Code, then you are in the right place. Watch this video until the end because I'm about to show you step-by-step process to configure Visual Studio Code for running C programs correctly. And I'm also gonna show you how you can code your first C program in Visual Studio Code on Windows 10 machine. So without further ado, let's get started. Firstly, we have need to download and install the C compiler. The best suited for our job is mingw. To download it, copy this link. I have provided this link in the video description. Now, open up your favorite web browser. I'm using Google Chrome here. Then paste the copied link into the search bar and hit enter. This is the third-party page for downloading mingw for Windows operating system. The best part about this site is that it contains self-extracting archive for mingw, which is super easy to install. Since this is a smaller in size and we don't need Git right now, we will use this one. Click on this mingw download link. And now you can see our mingw exe file is started downloading here. It's around 45 MB file at the time of recording. It will take some time to download. All depends on your internet connection speed. Our mingw installer exe file is downloaded successfully. Now click on Show in Folder. Now simply double click on this file. Here cancel all of this except C:// and click on Extract button. Let me minimize all the windows so that we can focus on installation part. And it started the extraction and installation process. It will take some time to complete. Now we need to add path in environment variable so that we can access GCC in Visual Studio Code. For that, double click on this PC and open local disk C. Here, open newly installed mingw directory. Then open bin folder and click on address bar. And finally copy this path. Now again go back to this PC and right click on this free space and select properties. Now click on advanced system settings. Here, click on environment variable button, select path, then click on edit button, and then click on new, and paste mingw path in the blank field, then click on OK button, OK again, and OK again. Good job. Now let's check is this working or not. For that, first, let me close unnecessary windows. And now click on Windows button. Then type cmd. Then click on command prompt. Here type gcc space dash dash version and press enter. And if you see something like this, then congratulations. You have successfully installed mingw gcc compiler on your Windows 10 machine correctly. You can skip this part if you already installed Visual Studio Code and directly jump to C configuration part. First of all, copy this link. I have provided this link in the video description. Open up your favorite web browser. I'm using Google Chrome here. Then paste the copied link in the search bar and hit enter. This is the official page for downloading Visual Studio Code for all the operating systems. Now, click on this blue download for Windows button. It says, thanks for downloading VS Code for Windows. And you can see VS Code installer file has started downloading here. It's around 68 MB file at the time of recording. Once the downloads gets finished, click on this up arrow and then select Show in Folder. We need to install this file. Simply double click on this file and it will start the setup wizard. Let me close all other windows so that we can focus on installation part. Here, accept the license agreement and click on Next button. Just leave it as default for the destination folder. Just make sure you have at least 259 MB of free disk space available and click on Next button. No need to change anything here, just click on Next. Check Create a desktop icon and don't forget to check Add to path. Click on Next. Now it's ready to install Visual Studio Code on your computer. We can click on Install button. It will take some time to install. It says completing the Visual Studio Code setup wizard. Check this box to launch Visual Studio Code. And finally, click on Finish button. This will automatically launch Visual Studio Code for the first time. We have successfully installed Visual Studio Code on Windows 10. Okay, now let's configure Visual Studio Code for running C programs. For that, firstly we need to install C extension in the Visual Studio Code. Press this extension button and in the search bar, type C/C++ and select the first option. Make sure it is from Microsoft. It will install C debugging and code browsing support. To install, click on this small install button. Now in the search bar, type code runner and choose the first option. Make sure it is from Junhan. Now again, press on this small install button. To run the code, you can press Ctrl+Alt+N, and to stop the code from running, you can press Ctrl+Alt+M. Now let's write some basic C program in the Visual Studio Code for testing. To create a new file in Visual Studio Code, you can click on File, then select New File. Now click on File and select Save As. Choose your preferred directory, I'm selecting desktop here. Give a name to your file, I'm writing subscribe.c, just don't forget to add .c at the end of the file for C program, otherwise it won't work. And then click on Save button. Let me quickly type a basic C program that prints subscribe now. Don't forget to save your program, otherwise it gives an error. Now let's save the program. For that, click on File and select Save. To run the program, you can press Ctrl+Alt+N. Or you can simply click on this small play button. And it works. See, subscribe now is printed here. If you followed the steps in this video and reach until here, I'm assuming this method has been working for you. So I'm requesting you to please like the video and subscribe to my channel. It won't cost you anything, but it will definitely boost my morale for making more such videos. Now let's create another program which takes input from the user. For that, let's create a new file. I'll name this file inputprogram.c and then click on Save. Okay, here I'm writing the code for the program that asks the user for its first name and last name and finally prints full name of the user back to the output console. Let's save the changes. Now run the code by pressing play button. So, our code is running but it's not displaying any output here. So this is the problem. First, let's stop this program by pressing Ctrl+Alt+M. As you can see, it's exited with the code 1. That means it stopped now. We can also close this output window. Now we can solve this problem by clicking on File, then select Preference, then select Settings. type run in terminal here and go down a little bit and find code runner run in terminal and check this box and cancel the settings and return back to our program. Now run the code by pressing run play button. Let me type my first name here. Now the last name. And now you can see my full name is printed here. So this is how you can run C program in Visual Studio Code. If you're interested in learning more about C language, then be sure to check out Beginner C Programming course in the video description. Subscribe and turn on the notifications so you don't miss more videos helping you to learn how to code and become a successful programmer. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.